You don't get anywhere by thinking inside the box, and to progress, you generally have to push yourself a little bit. For a car manufacturer, that generally means concepts and prototypes, and we're here at the Porsche Heritage Center, and I've dug out a few of the weirdos for us to have a look at. Welcome to the Freak Show.
I love a weirdo.
You may have noticed this one because it's kind of hard to miss, but this is the Porsche Panamericana concept from 1989, and it's got a lot of things going on. But funny story about this, it was kind of hinting at the styling for the future 993 generation of 911s, particularly around the headlights, but it was actually a bit of a birthday present for Ferry Porsche on his 80th birthday. Sounds cool, right? It's got a 247 brake horsepower flat six in the back. It's got really bulgy wheel arches, big tweaky suspension, double three spokes, which are about of their time as it's possible to get. The interesting thing about this car was that it was conceived as a kind of homage to that off-road race, the Carrera Panamericana. So what you do with this car is you can jack up the suspension and then change the wheels, and suddenly it's an off-roader. It's a bit of a dual-purpose machine. The only thing about it was that when it was actually given to Ferry Porsche for his birthday, he hated it, which again is quite awkward. One of my favorite details, it's got bespoke tires with the actual Porsche shield on them. It's got an unzippable neoprene roof, like a wetsuit, and the zips are purple. And the interior is kind of green and purple, but with a marbling effect. I'm starting to understand Ferry Porsche's reticence. What color is this? Answers on a postcard, please, because nobody knows. It's purple green. Bizarrely, Porsche actually apparently considered a small production run of this car, but it never actually made it. Which is a shame, really, because it's completely mad. Ugh. This is possibly one of the ugliest cars I think I've ever seen. It looks like a bar of soap with wheels. But this is actually a concept car from 1987 that was supposed to ape what the 356 Roadsters looked like back in 54. Can you see it? Kind of? Sort of? Well, some of the Roadsters that got imported to America chopped the windscreen down and then had this kind of tonneau cover that covered the passenger seat to keep things all aero. And this is that taken to an extreme. So you've got this cut down windscreen and then this whole body, which just makes it look really blobby. And then the weird thing about it is that the doors open normally, but then this tonneau bit kind of opens up and you slide up underneath it, which is awkward. But there are advantages to driving it. One, if you're inside, you don't have to look at the outside. And two, there's no passenger to share your shame. Of course, Porsche did end up doing modern Speedsters. They just didn't look as rubbish as that, thank God. Okay, this is definitely weird. It looks like a terrible Back to the Future copy. But this car had a point. It's basically trying to remove all of the external noise factors from any car so you can test tyres and see how noisy they were. So this rig isn't for emissions, it's to take away any and all exhaust noise. And on the front there's another sort of barrel-shaped thing which takes away all the induction noise. And then in the wheel arches it's got loads of padding and weird stuff to make sure that you couldn't hear anything but what the tyres were doing. It's actually an experimental car that works for a living. You want less mad but more absolutely awesome? Then this is the car for you. It's a 1987 928 H50 concept. Weird stat, until the Cayenne arrived in 2002, all mass production Porsches actually only had two doors. It is quite lovely in here. I mean, check out these leather seats. They're like little leather armchairs and they're electric and they move, apart from the battery is flat, so they don't move at the moment. But Porsche had actually done longer wheelbase versions of cars because they believed that an element of practicality was something good. And there'd actually been a proper long wheelbase four-seat 928 prototype. But this one is special because it's not just four-seat, it's four-door, obviously. So you've got a kind of suicide rear-doored shooting brake, which makes it one of, like, all of my favourite things in one car. Plus, it's purple, obviously. I definitely could make this work as a family car. obviously I couldn't make it work as a family car, but I'd try. You could think of this as sort of, kind of-ish, the grandparent to something like the Panamera. But actually, if you really want to see where this was going, we have to head over there. Where is it? There it is. So, Porsche was thinking all the time about something with four doors, and they came up with things like this. Now, this is a clay model of a car called the 932, and it basically looks like what a four-door Porsche might have looked like. This later became the 989, which looked a bit like a proper 911, just stretched and with four doors. But because of a slight financial crisis in Germany and the weak Deutschmark against the dollar, the car sort of disappeared and never appeared anything. But the thing that really interests me about this car is that one. You ready for this? Say what? What is a Mercedes W124 doing in the Porsche Heritage Center? It's a 500E, obviously. Check out the arches. Except it's not a 500E because it's a coupe. What this is actually a test mule for a four-door 989 Porsche. What Porsche needed to do was have something of a similar size and weight as a big car so they could test their new V8 engine. So that's what's under there. Actually, I think I can probably show you. So this is a Mercedes 124, W124, with a Porsche V8 heart. That is a proper Frankenstein. So this engine was being tested in this big car, and you got a little bit of Porsche mixed in with a whole lot of Mercedes. But the best bit isn't even the engine. Come and look inside it. So in here, it's a proper mashup. It's got a manual gearbox for the V8, Porsche seats, it's got W124 dials. I used to have one of these, so I kind of recognize them. And then a Porsche steering wheel. It's like a really weird mixture of the two cars, but you can bet one thing, it will be really reliable and quite fast. That's not a concept, it's a floor cleaning machine. Oh, actually, there is another Merc in this collection that's a bit of a prototype. This is a slight side quest, but just come with me and look at this G-Wagon. Look, see this thing here? There's a great story behind this. So basically, when Porsche had decided to do the Dakar with the 959, it needed to have some sort of support car to follow it. Now, it considered having another 959, but they were pretty crap at delivering spares and things because they didn't have the body for it. So Porsche got hold of a G-Wagon and then put the motor and transmission from a 928 S4 into it. So it's got just over 300 brake horsepower. And then it went out and competed because they weren't allowed to enter support cars. So they had to enter race cars. So this thing was officially registered, had this V8 in it, 5 litre. It was actually quite quick and could carry all the spares. It actually, as a support car slash race car, came in 6th, which is amazing. So this is another Porsche Sadies. And I think this is spectacular. It's not even been restored. So it's got broken bonnet, all the knacker ducts are all bent. It looks brilliant. The thing is, concept cars are very much of their time, and prototypes invariably aren't the finished article. That's the point. But Porsche has kept pushing the boundaries all the way through its career. There are loads more prototype Porsches in the world. These are just a few that happened to be in the store when we visited. And that's probably why Porsche makes some of the best cars in the business, because it's willing to make mistakes and learn. I'm all for it, to be honest, because as it turns out, some of the most interesting cars in the world are the ones that don't exist.